This is Spoken Gospel. We are dedicated to seeing Jesus in all of Scripture. In each episode, we see what's happening in a biblical text and how it sheds light on Jesus and his gospel. Let's jump in.
The Apostle Paul is on trial in Rome, and he's unsure he will survive. This is Paul's final letter, and he addresses it to his protege, Timothy, who he hopes will continue his ministry after his death. But Timothy is discouraged. The same false teachers Paul addressed in his first letter are still successfully deceiving churches despite his best efforts to stop them. But Paul encourages Timothy that their success is no reason to dismiss his own gift and leadership. Not only has Timothy inherited a sincere and vibrant faith from his mother and grandmother, but Timothy is also filled with God's Spirit. He doesn't need to be timid because God has filled him with the power, love, and self-discipline needed for the task ahead. While others are ashamed of Paul and his ministry, Timothy should know that by associating with Paul in his suffering, he's also joining himself to Jesus and his power. Jesus saved both Paul and Timothy by his death, and God called them both to ministry, not because they were braver than most, but because God decided that a murderous Pharisee and a timid Timothy would preach the resurrection life offered in Jesus. Timothy doesn't need to be discouraged. His faith is real. He is filled by God's Spirit, and God has chosen him. While others see Paul's imprisonment and suffering as reasons to reject his message, Timothy should guard the truth that their Savior was bound, suffered, and died to give life to all. Despite the claims of the false teachers, suffering is the way of Jesus and the path to resurrection. Followers of Jesus are like soldiers, unashamed of the suffering of war in hope of a certain victory. Or like athletes and farmers who are not ashamed to carry the weight of hard work and painful training to gain a harvest and prize. So while yes, Paul is bound in chains for the gospel, God's word is not bound. Jesus has risen from the dead, and if suffering is the path to resurrection, Paul and Timothy should be willing to endure whatever it takes to see more of God's children in eternity. Paul ends his opening paragraphs to Timothy with a hymn. It's one of the many songs composed by the first followers of Jesus, and it's meant as an additional encouragement to Timothy to not be ashamed and to not fear. The song says, "If we die with Jesus, we will live with God. And if we endure suffering, we will reign alongside God." They're solemn reminders of the inevitable suffering the gospel brings. But they're also impenetrable promises that not even death and chronic imprisonment can chain God, his gospel, or his followers. There's no reason Timothy should be ashamed of the gospel, even when it produces suffering. The gospel reminds us that when we suffer, Jesus' victory becomes ours. The song continues with encouragement to those of us who are unsure of how we would respond to Jesus' call to suffer. It says that if we deny God, God will deny us. But if we are faithless, he remains faithful because God cannot deny himself. Once we choose to share Christ's sufferings, we are inseparably joined to Jesus and his victory. There may be times when the burden of following Jesus will seem too great and the shame too deep. Timothy might have been on the edge of one of these moments himself. But God's faithfulness is more powerful than our faithlessness. He does not deny those with whom he has shared his grave. So be encouraged along with Timothy. Timidity, shame, or the times you've avoided suffering do not reverse your resurrection. God does not deny himself, and God will be faithful to bring you to eternal life. You will reign with him forever. May the Holy Spirit open your eyes to see the God who does not deny himself. And may you see Jesus as the one who died so that we can join him in his life.